Okay, hello everyone. Today I am going to discuss the refraction of light through prism and measuring the angle of deviation for this prism of incident ray with respect to the refracted ray. For this experiment we required the white paper, wooden board, glass prism, meter ruler, ballpoint or pencil and protector. Let's start our experiment. First of all, I am going to penetrate pins on soft wooden board in order to fix this paper, and then after that I am going to place this prism and drawing the sketch of this prism. Now this is our sketch of prism. Now I am going to draw the normal line on this prism, which is our reference line. So this is almost at a right angle to the side of the prism. So this is our normal line. Now with respect to normal line, I am going to take an arbitrary angle, which depends upon my own choice, and that arbitrary angle is basically angle of incidence for us. So let that angle I take here is for example, I am going to take that angle degree with respect to the 90 degree. This one is a 40 degree because this is a 10, 20, 30 and this is 40 degree. So let's our incident angle is 40 degree. This is our incident ray, this is the normal and this is the angle of incidence for us. Now place the prism again here and penetrate the soft wood pins on reference line. Now by penetrating the soft wood pins, you will see clearly the refraction of these two soft wood pins on the other side, which is this side in this case of these two soft wood pins. And then if you see the refraction of these two soft wood pins, then penetrate the other two pins in line with these two original pins such that we get the refracted ray for this incident ray. So now I am going to place two soft wood pins in line with the first two pins. So this will our refracted ray. Now I am going to show you that what is basically the refraction of these two soft wood pins. So you see very clear from this side that the refraction of the first two pins you see in prism, and the other two pins that I penetrated here, basically the original one, two pins, and the refraction of the other two pins are almost in a straight line. So after this, I remove these two soft wood pins and joining it with the reference line, also joining the incident ray with the refracted ray, because this is now becomes our refracted ray. Also draw normal line on this side for the refracted ray, such that how much this ray bends away or towards normal. So this is our normal reference line. Now by joining this normal line, the angle of emergence we can calculate with respect to this line, and it becomes roundabout 62 degree. So 62 degree is the angle of emergence for us, and the angle of incident for us theta I and theta E is basically angle of emergence is this is 40 and this is 62 degree. Now extend the refracted ray line and the incident ray line such that we can find the angle of incidence as well as the angle of refraction for this experiment as well as the angle of deviation. Now you see very clearly here that the angle of deviation for this experiment is round about 41, 42, 43, 45, 46, 47, almost 47 or 48 degree. So 48 degree is a angle of deviation. So angle of deviation for this experiment is a 48 degree, which is basically the angle of refracted ray. This is refracted ray with respect to the incident ray, which is basically the angle of deviation, which shows us that how much the refracted ray deviate with respect to the incident ray. And you see already clearly here that the angle of incident we measure is 40 degree, the angle of emergence is 62 degree, and the angle of deviation for this arrangement is 48 degree, which shows us that how much light ray is deviated with respect to the incident ray line. So thanks for your time. I hope you like this video, and be in touch with us. Also subscribe my channel, because our next video is more interesting than this. Thanks.